Hello, I am Bob, and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining channel. And in this episode, I'm going to cover sizing piping and pumps for Bitcoin home heating systems. But before getting on with the video, I want to mention some sponsors and affiliates of the channel, the first being Brains. So Brains is now selling their BMM 101 mini miner. And if you are just starting out, learning about Bitcoin and Bitcoin mining, this is the perfect miner for you. The BMM 101 mini miner can run off of any household power source using only 40 watts. Just plug it in, connect it to the internet, and start mining. You can explore what it is like to generate hash rate, join a mining pool, and mine Bitcoin. It is the perfect starter platform for you to start your own home Bitcoin mining journey. And for a limited time, if you click on the link below, you'll get a 10% discount on your own new BMM 101 mini miner. Next up is Fold. Fold offers a really cool Bitcoin debit card where you can get rewards in sats from your normal day-to-day spending. I've been using the Fold card for over a year now, and I've already accumulated almost 1 million sats without changing any of my normal spending habits. The card works with the Fold app, where you can buy and sell Bitcoin, buy gift cards, and set up direct deposits and payments, making it super easy to live on a Bitcoin standard. And if you sign up now using the affiliate link below, Fold will give you a bonus reward of 20,000 sats on your very first Fold card purchase. The Fold card is a great way to start living on Bitcoin. Just click the affiliate link below to get started today. Next up is SaaS mining. Now the focus of this channel is home mining, but let's face it, home mining isn't for everyone. Maybe your power costs are too high, maybe you live in an apartment, or maybe you just don't have enough time or expertise to build a home setup. In any of those cases, SaaS mining is for you. SaaS mining offers Bitcoin mining as a service. You pay for the miners and a monthly service fee, which includes electricity costs, and SaaS mining takes care of the rest. In return, you get a monthly Bitcoin payout from your miners, which allows you to build your Bitcoin stack at a discount. And if you act now and click the affiliate link below, you can get a $50 discount on every miner you buy. If you're looking for hassle-free Bitcoin mining, SaaS mining is a fantastic option. Okay, so in building a home heating system and routing hot fluid around a house, it's really important to get the piping and pump sizes correct. If piping is made too narrow, the pressure required to move fluid around the circuit might be so high that a really big and expensive pump is required. On the other hand, if the piping is made too large, you can spend a lot of money on oversized equipment, and it might be really hard to work out air pockets and bubbles out of the system. Now, just like in past episodes, I'll be pulling my information heavily from the Caleffi Idronics articles. I really can't recommend these enough. They are a fantastic resource for designing and building a home Bitcoin heating system. I've got links below that will take you to the exact articles used for this episode. Now, the key to sizing piping and pumps is to understand something called fluid head, which is measured in feet. Fluid head can be described as the mechanical energy put into a fluid, which might not make a lot of sense. So instead, just understand that a pump raises the head of the fluid, and then as the fluid passes through the hydronic system, it loses that head. If you can calculate the head loss of a system, you can figure out the matching pump size that you need to make it work. Now, there are a couple simple equations that can be used to estimate the head loss of a hydronic system. The first is this, which gives head loss in feet. In this equation, A is a fluid property factor, and here is a handy chart from the Idronics articles showing a range of values for water and some water glycol mixtures for a range of fluid temperatures. C is a pipe size coefficient. Again, the Idronics articles have a table with this information for a range of common pipe sizes and types. F is the fluid flow rate measured in gallons per minute. And finally, L is what is called the equivalent length of the hydronic circuit. Now, this equivalent length is a really easy way to account for the effect of all of the different piping and fittings. The idea here is to take all of the different components and assign an equivalent length to each one of them, and then add all of those equivalent lengths together to get the total equivalent length of the entire system. For straight piping, the equivalent length is just simply the length of the pipe itself. But for elbows, valves, and other fittings, you have to account for the added resistance to fluid flow, and so you can look up the equivalent length for each component. Again, the Caleffi articles have a handy table that will give you the equivalent length for a bunch of common fittings. And after adding up all of the equivalent lengths of all of the components, the total equivalent length is entered into the formula to get the head loss of the system. Now, in addition to pipes and fittings, there are also heat exchangers, radiators, and other large components in the hydronic fluid circuit. Manufacturers don't normally list an equivalent length for these components, and so a different approach is needed to calculate the head loss for these devices. Luckily, for many of these components, manufacturers will list a pressure drop across the device. If we have this data, we can estimate the head loss by using this simple equation, where D is the fluid density in pounds per cubic foot. You can easily find densities for water and glycol water mixtures in websites like the Engineering Toolbox. This is what I use, and I have a link below to that website. Now, the one tricky part of using this equation is that for most devices, the pressure drop will change with fluid flow rates. The higher the fluid flow rate, the larger the pressure drop through the device. Your manufacturer might only give you limited information here, so you might have to do a little guessing and then understand that your results might be a little off. Putting both of these equations together, we get a simple relationship between fluid flow rate and head loss. We can plot this on a chart, and what this shows is that the head loss can increase dramatically as fluid flow rate increases. And this makes sense, since for really low fluid flow rates, the resistance to fluid flow should be almost nothing. And at the other extreme, as you try and stuff more and more fluid down a pipe, you're going to need much higher pressure or head to make that work. Now, the next step is to start looking at pumps. Each pump manufacturer will provide you with what is called a pump curve chart. This describes how much pressure or fluid head a pump can generate at a given fluid flow rate. For typical circulator pumps, the pump head will drop off significantly at higher flow rates. And what this means is most circulator pumps will flow less fluid if they are pumping against a lot of flow resistance. The final step is to take the fluid head loss curve and the pump curve and put them on the same chart. When this is done, there's going to be an intersection between these two lines, and this intersection tells us how much fluid will flow through this hydronic circuit with this pump. Once you have this initial flow rate, you can then start to make changes to your system to increase or decrease this value. For example, if you think the flow rate is a little too low, you can increase the size of the piping, which will lower the head loss curve. This will move the intersection point to the right, meaning you'll get more fluid flow through the system with this pump. Likewise, if you think the flow rate is too high, you can decrease the pipe sizing. This will raise the head loss curve, resulting in less fluid flow for this pump. Another design option is to keep the piping the same and go with a different pump. There are many different pump designs out there, including pumps with higher or lower head capabilities, pumps with multiple speeds, or pumps that can produce a constant pressure or head output. Each pump curve can be added to the chart, and each will give you a different intersection, meaning a different fluid flow rate. You can compare different pumps with different pipe sizes to pick out the best overall design for your system. And with this method of calculating the system head loss curve and then plotting it along with the pump curve chart to get the fluid flow rates, you can start to compare and contrast different heating system layouts to get the best overall design for your home mining heating setup. And if you're interested in exploring different system layout options, here's a great video to get you started.